Hi, I'm Alex Webb, Master Putter Fitter here at the Ping Proving Grounds, and this is the Putting Lab. We're gonna start with the newest addition. We added a Zen Green Stage, Quintec Overhead, Quintec Projector. What that's gonna help us identify is a player's start line and aim tendencies. We're also using this in our A&T testing as well. So, engineering company, we test anything and everything under the sun. We've spent about a month testing hundreds of employees with their aim tendencies on the green stage and how it might benefit for future designs that we have. One really cool thing about the Zen Stage Green is just the adjustability of it. So identifying if players struggle with right to left putts, left to right putts, and we can actually adjust the green to see those players' tendencies. Click of a button, I can get it to 1%, 2%, 3%, right to left, up and down, all kinds of different putts where we can help players get better with their game. If we have players that miss right, if we have players that miss left, then I can cater to that by potentially giving them more toe hang, less toe hang. And it really helps us dial in based off of a player's natural tendencies and even their miss tendencies. And moving on, I have my workstation here. I've got a loft and lie. I've got a swing weight scale, a length gauge. I have a gram weight scale, an MOI machine. If I take a player's loft and lie, we do the fitting up here. I need to make small tweaks during the fitting. I can do that. I'll make the tweaks. We go back up there. We test it. We see if those tweaks worked. And if not, then we make more adjustments. So moving right along, we've got our major championship wall. Men's on this side, women's on this side. Our latest win is Maya Stark, 2025 US Women's Open. She used a 2024 Answer 2 putter. As we continue on, I've got the Ping table. This is the main focus. It's been the main focus of the lab for quite some time now. A little bit about the table. It's 45 foot, 10 inches long, 6.5 foot across. This is 5 pieces of solid black granite shaved down to 1/1000th of an inch. So it's perfectly level. Initially it was on the same foundation as the building. We were getting slight oscillations from the street outside. Like, that's not gonna work. We took the table up, we put it on its own foundation, perfectly level. That enables us to be highly precise in everything we do from a testing standpoint and a fitting standpoint. Next, we have the history wall, starting all the way at the 1A down at the end, working its way to the answer. 1966 is when the patent was established for that. We've got the Grand Slam here, 1988, where we won all 4 majors using a Ping putter. So as we work our way up the lab here, you can see we have putters on each side. What this allows us to do is to fit all types of players, multiple different types of milling patterns, face inserts, alignment features, so we've got everybody covered. As I work my way around, we've got our putter robot right here. This was designed by one of our engineers in-house. It enables us to take the human element out and have complete control over delivery of the club head. Our engineers are able to isolate specific variables such as face insert, groove geometry, and CG location. By delivering the club the same every time, we're able to see how design changes impact the ball launch conditions. Moving around here, I'm gonna talk about the tools that we use to fit players. We'll start with motion view. There's cameras on both sides here. We have left-handed face on, we have right-handed face on. If you look at the screen here, I brought up some video of Tony Finau. Eyeline is obviously something that's really important in the putter fitting. We want to make sure that eyes are just over the ball or just inside the ball. The shaft rotates around the hosel, so making sure that the eyes are in a good spot is ideal. Next, we have iPing 2.0, proprietary software that we designed in-house. Basically, what this does is it measures the motion of the putter at certain points in the stroke, and it kicks back some data to us. Within this data, we've got closing angle, impact angle, tempo, lie angle, shaft lean. The biggest thing with this is consistency. With a lot of this stuff, there's not a right or wrong to it. We just want the player to be consistent. For us, closing angle, at Ping, we fit for 3 types of putters, straight, slight, and strong. This is going to help us identify how much rotation or how little rotation a player applies from the top of the backstroke to impact. This helps us identify how much toe hang we give a player or how little toe hang we give a player. That's one of the most important metrics along with impact angle, which is going to be the face at setup compared to where it is at impact. If we talk about putting, putting is direction and speed. That's why impact angle is so important. One really cool thing about iPing is it provides a handicap for each metric that we look at. That's what we see in the green boxes here. It also provides an overall handicap as well. The last tech that we use here in the Ping Putting Lab is going to be Quintech Ball Roll, which what's really cool about this is we can pair Quintech Ball Roll with iPing data. So iPing we use for club data, Quintech Ball Roll we use for ball data. What's really great about Quintech Ball Roll is that it measures basically everything about the ball roll. We've got launch data, we've got forward and back spin. We always want forward spin, don't want back spin. It's measuring side spin, whether it's hook spin or cut spin, start a forward rotation and then zero skid after, along with ball speed as well. This is vital for us to dial in a player with the club data, the ball data, and marry those two together. So Quintech and all the tools that we use here in the Ping Putting Lab not only help us fit players for the best putters for their game, but they help us in the design process for putters that you see in golf bags everywhere.